Early this week, the country was in shock over the gruesome murder of 28-year-old Susan Magara, who was first kidnapped and went missing for about 20 days. Yesterday too, a woman narrowly escaped death in Bweyogere when kidnappers attacked her. The increasing spate of abductions and murders are the reason why the leader of opposition, Winnie Kiiza, demands that parliament be recalled from recess to find solutions to the insecurity in the country. Kiiza says that if by next week parliament is not recalled, she will collect signatures of different legislators, which will persuade parliament to resume immediately.
It is too sad. May parliament come back. If it doesn't come back next week, we are going to move around with this, collecting signatures for MPs to come back, and we make sure that we discuss in details the killings of Ugandans. It is unbecoming, it is beshaming of a country, it is eroding our pride, it is putting us to shame.
The opposition legislators also want Minister of National Security, General Henry Tumukunde, the Minister of Internal Affairs, General JJ Odong, the Inspector General of Police, General Kale Kayihura, and UCC boss Godfrey Mtabazi to resign before being subjected to a vote of no confidence.
If those responsible, like I have said, for the security of this country are not taking responsibility and stepping aside, Parliament should show them the exit. And in fact, most of them have overstayed their welcome. They need to go.
When the NRM government came into power, they promised Ugandans fundamental change. And indeed the fundamental change was premised on peace and security. But to our disappointment and dismay, this has not happened.
Kiiza further asked the security agencies to explain why a lot of force is used against opposition campaigns and not in the fight against abductions and murders in the country.
At whatever point this classified information will be shared for the protection of Ugandans, maybe it's only when they are coming to beat up opposition politicians and beating up members of parliament.
I wish the police would take the responsibility to protect the lives of the people of this country, such that we do not only talk about the young lady who was killed. I felt so bad about that young woman. I can't imagine what she went through with her fingers cut off to convince the parent that we need our money, whoever you were. So it's a whole case of police failing to do its work.
Last year, over 20 women were murdered in Wakiso district. However, in a report presented before parliament, Minister JJ Odong said that Illuminatis is responsible for the mysterious murders. This report was filed by Rachel Nakasi for Urban TV.